We're gonna rock with our purple today. We're gonna rock with our purple. Welcome back, everybody. You back. And if you're new, welcome. This is CPA Strength. I'm the strongest licensed CPA in the state of Florida. Yeah, see right there? Yeah. So I am the strongest licensed CPA. What do you do over here, buddy? What do? I motivate, educate, and inspire these people. You people, the viewers, I educate, motivate, and inspire. It's a lot of fun. I love it. Anyways, before we get into this video, I have a certain playlist that I'll show you over here with this card. I have a whole playlist that's changing lives over here. It's the best playlist in the world, guaranteed by me, okay? Take it up with me. Anyways, after you watch that, you might come back. I'm going crazy. Anyways, let me calm down. What are we gonna do? This is number 68. I just can't believe I've done 67 before this one. This one we're doing contribution margin. The one in 67 we were fixed and variable costs. So we're using the same numbers in this one, in number 68. And it's contribution margin. What contribution margin is the definition of it? Is excess of sales over variable costs. Like we have a sales price of $200 per, we're selling tax returns. So we have a sales price of $200 per tax return. So excess of sales over variable costs. Variable costs are 50. Are 150 over here. Oh, can you even see that? Can you see that? See I'm working with lights. You see the shadows. It's getting crazy over here, right, folks? Woo! Man. Yeah, I'm just going to take the hat off halfway through. I'll get this lighting stuff figured out. It's, you know, the show must go on. I got to get good content out first of all. So, I'm going to keep on trying to get the good content coming out, and the quality is going to step up so probably incrementally that you won't notice it. So I'm trying to say, so that's the excess of sales over variable costs. You know, the sales price 200, variable cost 50. So 150 per unit is the contribution margin. And I'm like, well, you know, usually I have the way that I keep it straight in my head. And you know, like a little, like the trick that helped me or whatever, but I don't have one for contribution margin. You know, if you can't remember what contribution margin is, then you're just gonna have to, you know, write it next to DC Adler or write it on your paper every morning when you're studying and just say contribution margin is, you know, sales over variable costs or however you can remember it. Sorry, the fixed costs would be like a rent, a telephone bill or a Wi-Fi bill, cable, something that doesn't change, it's fixed, doesn't change per usage. The variable costs only occur or change when you're selling units. Like we're selling tax returns or we're preparing tax returns, and every time we prepare a tax return and sell it to someone for $200, it costs us $50 to go through our tax software. So that our variable cost per unit is $50. But anyways, once we can figure out that our contribution margin is $150, so that means every time we sell one unit, every time we do one tax return, we're making $150. So that's our contribution margin. So once we figure that out, once we figure out our contribution margin, $150, then you know it's $600 is the fixed cost. So that's what we need to cover. So you can find out a couple things. You know, your break even point. You can have a target, like how much you hope to make, or all kinds of formulas and ratios are derived from the contribution margin. So that really, that's why I picked this one to show you after we went over fixed and variable costs. We did the graph. I hope you liked the graph. I thought it was cool. I wanted to do contribution margin because it's a very important ratio. For, you know, it's just behind a fixed and a variable cost is the contribution margin. So I know I went all the way around. Anyways, we're gonna show you the contribution margin and the unit contribution margin. So this is just the regular contribution margin in the book. Well, let's say you sell 10 units. So I'm selling 10 tax returns, right? 10 units, tax returns, doing 10 tax returns. Uh-huh. And I'm selling each tax return for $200, right? And so that's the sales per unit. The variable cost per unit is $50, because that's how much the tax software costs per tax return. The fixed cost is $600. That's my rent. That's my phone and my Wi-Fi, my Wi-Fi. Doesn't matter how much I use per month. It's gonna stay the same. Let's try to figure out with these facts here. 10 units sold, 10 tax returns sold, $200 a piece for sales, $50 variable cost per unit, per tax return, and $600 for fixed costs. Let's get the contribution margin. So total sales, 10 units times $200 is $2,000 in total sales, minus our variable costs, and that's going to be our contribution margin. That's gonna be our profit before the fixed costs, right? It's profit before the fixed costs. I was saying earlier in the video, I just caught that I was saying it's a profit. It's not the profit, it's a profit before the fixed costs. I guess that's why they don't call it profit. That's why they call it contribution margin. Because it's your margin that you have to contribute to, maybe, I don't know. So the variable cost for 10 tax returns is $50 each, is $500. So you would subtract $500 from $2,000, you get $1,500. That's the contribution margin. You have the 10 units, because you've sold 10 units. Now the contribution margin, see, 200 minus 50 for one is 150, so you can get your unit price right there. And that's another unit contribution margin. That's another factoring, which I like a little bit better. But anyways, sales minus variable costs, sales over variable costs, that's a contribution margin. 2,000 minus 500 is 1,500, but you could also get it per unit, because per unit's 200 minus 50, 150 per unit. But if we're doing the contribution margin and the total here, you'd have $1,500 profit for 10 units, $1,500 contribution margin, so profit before fixed. Then you'd pay out your fixed cost of $600, so you have $900 profit. So that's contribution margin. But now let's go over here to the unit contribution margin. Now this just the unit contribution margin just intuitively makes more sense to me. I like to just see that I'm making 150 a pop here. Instead of doing all this, I would say, how much per unit am I making? Because I just want to know, like, 150 per unit before my fixed costs. Like, I just want to know that number. So I would just take. Oh, the sales price per unit 200, variable cost per unit minus 50, 150, and then I'd say, how many sales do we do? 10, 150 times 10, 1,500. But I would like to see this, the contribution margin, so I would know that, hey, 150, I would know four of these, and I can get my break-even point. Anyways, I thought the air was on or something, but I'm getting extremely sweaty now, and it's getting hard to think, and everything, all of that such. Anyways, I hope you enjoyed this one on contribution margin. I hope I see you in the next video. Please, if you like this, like, share, subscribe. Yes, like, share, subscribe, comment, all that good stuff, please. And I'll see you in the next one. And of course, stay positive, okay? Also, yes, this is a hater-free zone. Hater-free, man, we ain't got time for that, okay? We ain't trying to throw shade on nobody, all right? We're trying to uplift and promote everybody, all right? Well, everybody, if they're doing good, we don't promote haters or mean people. Well, anyways, I'll see you next time. Deuces. Every day it's the same old thing. Suckers talking like they with it, but they ain't no man. Got killers in the squad, they don't play no games. And if the police get me, I don't say no names. Get my brother back in jail, man, I hate the
those chains. Got little homies out here that'll take your chain. I be fucking with the mob, I don't bang no gang. When I was young, I was broke, I had to slay coke.